Good morning. In Matthew chapter 18, verse 20 says, "For where two or three are gathered together in my name, I am there in the midst of them." So I hope that everyone here enjoy this worship for the name, for the honor and for the honor of God. I hope that everybody here is ready to receive the Holy Spirit. Welcome to the Lord's house.
Page 86, How Great Thou Art.
Then sings my soul.
Our next song is page 334, Come Thou Fount. Our opening song is page 598. If you can please stand, Watch Ye Saints 598.
Watch ye saints with eyelids waking, lo the powers of heaven are shaking. Keep your lamps all trimmed and burning, ready for your Lord's returning. Lo, he comes, lo, Jesus comes, lo, he comes all glorious, Jesus comes to reign victorious. Kingdoms at the base are crumbling, hark, his chariot wheels are rumbling, tell, oh, tales of grace abounding, while the seventh trump is sounding. Lo, he comes, lo, Jesus comes, lo, he comes all glorious, Jesus comes to reign victorious. Lo, he comes. Christ his kingdom hasteneth greatly, earth our late, his pains are summing. Shout ye saints, your Lord is coming. Long he comes, Lord Jesus comes. Long he comes all glorious. Jesus comes to reign victorious. Long he comes, yes, Jesus comes. Sinners come with
Father, it's so good to be in your house this morning. We've come to worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and thank you, Lord, for what you've done in our lives and through us this week. And Lord, now, as I pray for your people here. I pray for our families to put a hedge about each one, and that, Lord, we can be that people, your people, the remnant, and we are watching. We are those saints that are watching and waiting for your coming. Oh, Lord, it doesn't matter what's around us. It matters who is in us as we go forward. And, Lord, thank you again for this church. Thank you for this people right here, for their vision of helping people. So may you bless this church service. May you bless us as we read your scriptures, as you teach, as you grow in us. Today we ask in you, our God, to bless us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hear our prayer, O God.
Open our Bibles and in Luke 7, 13 through 15. When you have it, can you say a strong amen? Luke 7, 13 through 15. Amen. And it says, when the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her and said to her, do not weep. Then he came and touched the open coffin, and those who carried him stood still. And he said, young man, I said to you, arise. So he who was dead sat up and began to speak, and he presented him to his mother. Amen.
Thank you.
When I was about six years old, maybe seven. And after school, I would always go to my grandma's house. And my grandma's house was very clean, but she had lots of pretty things around the house, little knickknacks. And above her fireplace, she had all these little statues of little boys playing with their dogs or little girls playing with a cat. And they looked so interesting and so cute that I always wanted to touch them. Now, my grandmother told us never, ever touch her little statues and her little knickknacks without asking her. She said, if you ask me, I will take it down for you and let you touch it. But make sure you ask me first. Well, I was the kind of person that sometimes didn't like to ask. And so there was one thing that I really was scared of the most. I really hated people getting mad at me. I hated my teachers getting mad at me. I hated my parents getting mad at me. I hated anybody getting mad at me, my friends. And are any of you guys like that? Yeah? And so I never talked in school because I never wanted to get in trouble. I never wanted the teacher to yell at me. And my grandma, she somehow knew that. She knew that I was afraid of people yelling at me. So she came and she told all of us kids, she said, if you ever do anything naughty secretly, if you come and tell me, you won't get in trouble. I won't get mad at you, she said. I won't yell at you. Just tell me. So there was one day I came in from playing outside in her yard and I saw those cute little statues above her fireplace. And I thought, you know, I'm old enough now that I won't break her statues. And I kind of called out Grandma's name and she didn't answer. So I thought, well, I'm not going to go look for her. I'm just going to go and I'll carefully take it off the fireplace mantle and I'll look at it just a little bit and I'll put it back. And so I went over there and I took it off the mantle, carefully looked at it, put it back, and I don't know how it happens, but sure enough, it fell and broke into lots of pieces. And I could have ran out right then, because I had lots of brothers and sisters. And she could have come and looked at it and found it broken and could have asked who did it, and no one would admit to it. But I remembered her words. If you tell me something you did naughty, I won't get mad at you and you won't get in trouble. And so I remember standing there in that room thinking, do I go tell her or do I run away? And those words kept going through my mind, I won't get mad at you, I won't get mad at you. So I went and I told my grandma, I told her, I broke your little statue. And she said, which one? And I saw the look on her face. And I showed her which one it was, and it was her favorite one. And she didn't get mad at me, and she didn't yell at me, but she cried. And I felt so terrible that I did that to my grandma. But it reminds me that Jesus said the same thing. He said, if you will confess your sins, He is faithful and just to forgive you your sins and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. So Jesus is the same way as my grandmother. Tell Him and He will forgive you. And you know, she never yelled at me and never did anything to me, but I never did that again because I hurt her. Let's pray.
Dear Jesus, be with all the houses that got hit by the hurricane. Be with those who don't have a home. Help everybody to be able to clear things. Help those who don't have electricity to get it soon. And thank you for your love. Help us to show it to others. In your name I pray, amen.
How many of you like this special music? Okay. Okay, now is the time for Benny Bradford for the special music.
Is entitled No More Night, and they're going to sing along while I play the trumpet, and I hope you're blessed. And on the last verse, please join in if you know the song.
Yeah, he will repeat the chorus, so join in on the repeat.
Thank you.
the timeless theme, earth and heaven will pass away. It's not a dream, God will make all things new that day. Gone is the curse from which I stumbled and fell. Evil is banished to eternal hell. No more light, no more pain, no more tears, never crying.
Savior, eternally, everyone join in.